So welcome to the final video where we will solve this print sorted function. So before we do that, let's add some things over here. So whenever we want to find a number, let's print for the user, enter the number you want to find, like this. Perfect. And also we have to modify one more thing. Over here, as we saw before, we want to add backslash n. Perfect. Now let's see this print sorted. So you can consider this function a 2-in-1. Since we don't want to modify the original array, then what we're going to do is to copy our array into a new array and sort the new array and print it. So we will copy the array and sort the new array. Now as you can see, my header file is not open over here. So we go over here, double click this, and it is open. So I want to add an extra function. So in order to practice more, this function is called copy array. So it takes two arrays of integers, so array 1 and also array 2. So basically, we will copy array 1 to array 2. And to make this more clear, let's call this source and let's call this destination, like this. So we will copy this to this, okay? Now let me take this prototype, save the file, go to our C file, and now let's implement the function. So it's pretty easy to copy an array to another array. Of course, we are supposing these two arrays have the same size. So let's iterate over the elements. Int I equals 0, I will be less than the size, and in this case the size of both arrays will be the counter. Okay, you will see that in a little bit. And let's increment I. If you want to write this function and the size is not the counter, basically you give the size as a parameter. Okay, so this is not a problem. Now in the loop over here, we want to say that our destination sub I is equal to our source sub I, and this is it. So destination 0 equals source 0, destination 1 equals source 1. So as you can see, after we exit this function, we end up with a copy of source inside destination. And since arrays are passed by reference, the original destination array will be modified. Now I'm going to use this function inside the print sorted function. So let me get the prototype. So we have to modify it. This function takes an array and prints it, right? So let me copy this, save the file, and now let's implement our function. Let's add some more spaces. Okay, now we will write the code. First of all, I want to make a new array to copy this array to. Okay, so let's call this array 2, or something like copy. Okay, and this array will has the same size, so its size is counter. This is perfectly valid. Now we have our second array, and we want to copy this array to this one. So we simply use our function. So copy array, our source is the array, and our destination is the copy, right? Let us stop over here and print the array. So print array and print the copy. So I just want to show you that the copy array function is working. Let's go to our main function. Let's remove this comment, and the print sorted is number 4. So let's put number 4 over here. So build the program, see the logs. Perfect, we have an error. So we have to give this function the array, of course. Now build the program again. Zero errors, zero warnings. Run the program. So let's add some numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now let's print sorted. So we choose 4, press enter. And as you can see, this is the copy array. It is the same as our original array. So this is our original array. As you can see, they are the same. Perfect. So let's go continue implementing our function. Let me close this. Go over here. Okay. So now the easiest way to sort an array is the following. Let's start by iterating over all the numbers. So int I equals 0, I will be less than the counter, and I plus plus. So this loop will be iterating over the copy array, okay? Now in this loop, we will iterate also over all the elements after the element that we are at. So int j is equal to I plus 1, and the j will also be less than counter and j plus plus. So let me tell you what I'm doing. Let's consider this array over here, 5, 1, 2, 3, 6, okay? So this loop will start at 5, at index 0. And this loop, in this case, will start at 1. So the second loop will start over here. And you already know, this loop will finish, and this loop will still be at the first element. So we are taking into consideration 5. This is array sub I. Now we will iterate over these elements and compare each one with array sub I. So these over here are array sub j. So if we find an element that is less than 5, we will swap this element with 5. So let's do this. Is array sub 0 greater than array sub 1? Yes. So we have to swap them. Now we put 1 over here and 5 over here. Now this is still array sub 0. Now j++, we have this element over here. Is this element less than this element? The answer is no. So j++. Is this element less than this element? No. Is this element less than this element? No. So as you can see, we have the smallest element at the beginning of the array. Now this loop is finished. So we go up here and we make I++. So this is array sub I now. So we'll do the same comparison. So is this element less than this element? The answer is yes. So swap them. 2 over here and 5 over here. Now we are still using this element. So is this one less than this one? No. Is this one less than this one? Also no. As you can see, we are sorting our array. Now the same thing will happen. We make I++. So we are working with this 5. We compare to the rest of the elements. And we are basically getting the minimum and putting it over here. So 3 will be swapped with 5. Now I++, we are also working with 5. So we don't do anything. Then I++, now we are working with this element. So j will be equal to 4 plus 1, which is 5. And 5 is not less than 5. So we will not do anything and we will exit this loop. Now I++, now I is also equal to 5. 5 less than counter is not true. So we exit this loop and as you can see, we sorted our array. So let's do this. If we find an element that is less than array sub I, we will swap them. So if array sub I is less than array sub j, let's make a function called swap that takes the array and takes the index I and the index j and swaps the two elements, array sub I and array sub j. Okay, so over here, the type of this function is void. It's called swap. It takes an array of integer. It takes the first index I and it takes the second index j. Now let's take the prototype, save the header file. And now let's implement this function over here. Let me add some spaces. Okay. Now, basically, we want to swap array sub I with array sub j. Okay. Let's suppose array sub I is equal to 2 and array sub j is equal to 3. So I will say int temp is equal to array sub I. So temp is equal to 2. Okay. Now, I will say that array sub I is equal to array sub j. So array sub I is now equal to 3. And over here I will say array sub j is equal to temp. So array sub j is equal to 2. As you can see, array sub I was equal to 2 and now it is equal to 3. And array sub j was equal to 3 and now it is equal to 2. So we swap the values. And since the arrays are passed by reference, the change that we do over here will affect the main array. Perfect? Okay, so this is our function. This is a very weak way of sorting an array, but for us, it will do just fine, okay? So after we sort the array, we basically want to print it. So let's use our print array function and give it our copy array. And by the way, I made a big mistake over here. We want to sort the copy array, not the original array. So this over here should not be array, it should be copy. Let's fix this. Over here put copy and here put copy. And by the way, I hope you are seeing the power of making functions. For example, we wrote this function only once and we are using it in multiple places. So what we did over here actually sorts our array in decreasing order. Because look what we are doing. I actually made this by mistake. So I'm saying if the element that we are at in the first loop is less than another element, then I'm swapping these two elements. So I'm bringing a bigger number and swapping it with the number that we are working with. So using this code, we will end with an array sorted in a decreasing way. If we want to sort it in an increasing way, we should look for a number that is less than the copy sub I. So if copy sub I is greater than copy sub j, this means that we are bringing a smaller number and swapping it with the number that we are working with. So using this code, we will get sort in an increasing way, like over here, okay? So let's go to our main function, build the program, see the logs, everything is perfect, run the program. So let me fill the array, so add number. So let's print our array. We have 90523. What we expect to see when we print sorted is the following: 0, 2, 3, 5, 9. So let's print sorted. As you can see, we have our solution perfectly. And what's important, the original array, here it is, it is not affected. Now, if you want to see the decreasing order, let's go over here, change this to less than. Let's go to our main, build, run the program. I'm going to enter some numbers. So this is our array, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, if we print it, we expect to see 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So 4, enter, and we have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So we can add a number, remove a number, print our array, sort the elements, find a number, and finally, we will exit our program. So press 6, enter, and goodbye. I'm so happy. So really congratulations for making it this far. And I hope you are getting a lot from these questions. I'm putting everything I have to make this video for you. So thanks a lot for coming this far, and I'll see you in the next video.